Hello and welcome to another Unity tutorial. Today we will have a look at how we rotate an object. This can be done in a lot of different ways, so here we will have a look at the three most common ways to rotate an object. Let's have a look at method number one, using the update method in C#. Okay, let's say we have this wonderful gem and we would like to rotate it on the Z-axis. Right-click and select Create C# Script and call it something like Rotate. We have to drag it to the gem and then we can actually double-click on the script to open Visual Studio. We are only interested in the update method, so we can just delete the first part of the script. Okay, let's go for the Rotate script. It could be something like this. Transform.rotate. And then we have to define a new vector 3 inside that. So new vector 3. And inside that we have to define the values of the x, y, and z. Let's go for 0, 0, and 1. Let's switch to Unity and see how it works. Whoa, so cool. It was almost too easy, right? To make sure that the animation runs at the same speed on every device, we have to times with time.delta time. The delta time is a very small number, so we have to change the value to 100. Now let's test in Unity and we can see the result is still very smooth. And now the animation runs at the exact same speed on every device. Now let's have a look at rotation method 2, using Unity's animation tools. Before we continue, we just have to remove the script from the gem. Okay, now select the gem and go to the animation window and hit create. Let's create a new animation folder. We could call that for just animations. And inside that, we will save our new animation. We could call it something like gem and rotate. Now there's a new add property button. Let's click that and select transform and rotation. Very nice. Unity have made some keyframes for us. Let's open the rotation animation and look at the values. We could go to the last keyframe and add the Z value 360. And here we go. We have a rotation animation. But when we run the animation, we are not so happy. We would like a more steady animation. We can work on that by clicking on the Curves tab. We have to adjust the blue curve. And let's see if we can make that as a straight line. We could also adjust the yellow and the red one. That's the X and Y values. But for this animation, we will just delete them. Let's run the animation and see how it looks. It's very nice and smooth. Okay, it's time for my personal favorite, rotation method 3, using a tween tool. Before we dive into that, let's delete the current animation. We can just select the keyframes and press delete. In this video, we will use the iTween tool. You can use DOTween as well or any other C# tweener. Search for iTween in the asset store or just follow the link in the description. Okay, now let's create a new script. We could call that RotateTween. We still have to drag the script to the gem and double click on it to open Visual Studio. To start the animation, we have to call the tween tool only once. So let's aim for the start method this time. We can do it in just one sentence and it goes like this. iTween.rotate2. And inside the brackets, we have to define the object. It will be this game object and the iTween hash. The hash contains all the parameters for the animation. So let's just start. We'll go for it's the Z axis and let's make that for 180. And we have the time. We set that to 1.5 seconds. And we also have to define the ease type. I could just write my favorite ease type here, but if you're new to iTween, I think you should do this as a public variable. Let's create that. Public iTween.easeType, easeType, semicolon. We also have to define the loop type. And again, let's do this as a public variable so we can control it outside the script. Public iTween loop type, loop type, semicolon. And of course, we will finish the line with the loop type variable. Back in Unity, we can now access these public variables as dropdowns. And let's select the ease in out bounds and test the result. It doesn't look that good, it's way too fast. Anyway, let's change it to linear and the loop type to loop. Yay! A really nice and good looking animation. That was all for today. Thanks for watching and see you soon to another Unity tutorial.